I'm going to be explaining Adobe's brand new Enhance Speech tool and showing how you can make any audio sound absolutely incredible in just one click. You can literally take audio that sounds like this.
Dear Kaylee, today is the day. After today, no one can make fun of you for your last name. You're welcome.
That was recorded on camera, no lav mic. You can hear all the background audio and how distant he sounds from the microphone to this.
Dear Kaylee, today is the day. After today, no one can make fun of you for your last name. You're welcome.
That is the exact same audio file just processed using the enhanced speech tool, and it sounds like he's wearing a mic. It's mind-blowing stuff. Also, to help save you time, I've created a set of enhanced speech presets for this tool that are going to help you dial the effect in and make your audio sound better even faster. You can download these presets completely for free at the link down in the video description. Also, this video does have a sponsor, and it's my friends at MediaZilla. MediaZilla is the best way to share your videos with your clients because you can easily customize a beautiful interface that looks like Netflix for them to watch. There's no ads or copyright claims to worry about, and MediaZilla recently introduced a new feature that will actually make you more money as a filmmaker by letting you sell videos to your clients inside MediaZilla. Let's say you wanted to create a wedding video, but you wanted to sell a video of the wedding ceremony to the couple as an add-on. You can now put the ceremony video behind a paywall, and MediaZilla will handle all of the payment processing and give the couple access to the video after they pay. So click the link below right now to sign up for a free 14-day trial and get a bonus 50 gigabytes of storage, and you can see for yourself why MediaZilla is the best way to send videos to your clients and make extra money in the process. Getting right into it now, what is this Enhance Speech tool? Well, back in late 2022, Adobe released a tool on their website called Podcast AI Enhance Speech, and this tool really took the filmmaking and podcasting community by storm because it uses AI to, as the name implies, enhance any audio file uploaded to it of someone speaking, and it is, in a word, insane. If your audio is too quiet, if it has too much echo, maybe your recorder that you had on a person speaking died, and the only audio that you have is from your on-camera mic that was recording them 20 feet away across the room, it doesn't matter. This tool could fix it. It was magical. But it did have one big drawback. Namely, to use it, you have to upload your audio file to Adobe's site, and this is a pain, especially if it's a long audio file. You may have to edit it to make it shorter, the processing will take longer, it's just not ideal, especially if you're trying to edit a video quickly. Well, I have good news, because in the Premiere Pro 24.2 update, Adobe officially added this same enhanced speech tool directly into Premiere Pro. So now you do not need to go to Adobe's website, upload your audio file, or do any of that, because you can now enhance the audio in your video in just one click in Premiere Pro, and you also have control over the level of enhancement that you're going to be adding to your audio as well. So here's how it works. You're going to want to start by importing some footage with audio into Premiere Pro, or if you have separate audio files that you want to import, it doesn't matter. You just need to have audio, and you need to put this audio on your timeline. In this case, I have a video clip that I recorded at a wedding of a groom reading a letter, and for the sake of this demo, we're going to pretend that my audio recorder failed. So all that I was left with was the on-camera microphone audio of the groom speaking, and here's how it sounds.
Dear Kaylee, today is the day. After today, no one can make fun of you for your last name. You're welcome.
And as you can hear, it's pretty rough. It's faint, there's echo, there's wind. None of this is ideal, and this would be a lot of work if I was trying to finesse this audio to use it in the wedding film. Thankfully, audio like this that may have been completely unusable in the past can now be saved with the Enhance Speech tool. To access Enhance Speech, all you have to do is go up to Window, enable the Essential Sound panel, which is going to open up this cute little panel over here on the right, and then you're going to want to click to select your audio clip that you want to enhance, and then you're going to want to tell Premiere Pro what type of audio this is, which in this case, it is dialogue, so we're going to select that, and here it is, the Enhance Speech tool. Now remember how I said we can enhance this speech in one click? Here's the one click. Click enhance. It's going to do some analysis. Boop, okay, it's done. Really, that fast. Premiere Pro may take a few seconds or longer depending on how long your audio track is, but let's see how this sounds.
Dear Kaylee, today is the day. After today, no one can make fun of you for your last name. You're welcome.
What? That sounds so good. So crisp, so clean. It sounds like he's wearing a microphone. Now that said, what if it didn't sound so good? Thankfully, because we are in Premiere Pro, we have this very helpful slider down here that says mix amount below the enhanced speech button. And if you're wondering what mix amount means, well, if you mouse over this button here, it's gonna say sets the level of enhancement applied to the original audio clip. So this is really a way to adjust the strength of the enhanced speech effect. So let's now try an experiment. Let's crank this all the way up to 10 and see how it sounds. Dun, dun, dun.
Dear Kaylee, today is the day. After today, no one can make fun of you for your last name. You're welcome.
That is so crisp. Oh my goodness. Isn't that just a crazy effect? That said, I do want to warn you that the higher that you increase this enhanced speech slider, the greater chance that the audio is going to sound more digital and the voices that it's modulating are going to start sounding more robotic. In my experience, setting the level to 10 is pretty much a guaranteed way that whoever's speaking is going to sound like an alien. So I would only do that if you have super terrible audio and you need it to be recovered no matter what. That said, I do want you to also know that the higher that you set the enhanced speech level, the more that's going to sound like it was recorded in a studio environment, meaning that the voice of whoever is speaking is going to become more and more prominent, and the background sound is going to become quieter and quieter. So if you have someone speaking with a lot of background noise, going up to level 7 or 8 or 9 may be what you have to do to clean up the audio. In this case, it sounds like the groom speaking here is in a studio. It's so clean with no background audio. It's pretty nuts. Here's where things can get really interesting though, and may hurt your brain a little bit whenever I explain this to you, because it definitely hurt mine the first time that I heard it. Example time. I was filming some friends of mine as they filmed a wedding for a future wedding behind the scenes video, by the way. And whenever this couple had their first look and they saw each other for the first time, it was a really sweet moment where they were saying some really great things for the video, but it was also a very windy day and the audio needed to be cleaned up. So my friends used the enhanced speech tool in Premiere Pro to fix this audio. But the issue was that when they did this, the audio was cleaned up so much to the point that it sounded like the couple was recording in a studio and not outdoors on a windy day. In short, the audio did not match up with the ambience where it was recorded. So to fix this, my friends actually went in and added a subtle wind sound effect to the audio, literally making the enhanced audio less perfect than an Adobe Enhance Speech made it. And when they did that, the video felt just right. The audio was still clear and easy to understand and significantly better than it was before the enhanced speech effect was applied, but the added wind noise sound effect that was applied made everything sound even better and significantly more natural. So, what I'm recommending to you may sound weird, but if you really want to dial things in properly when using the enhanced speech tool, it may make the audio a little too perfect and you may have to add imperfections back to it. It's kind of like adding film grain to a digital video clip, right? We as filmmakers want to make the video not look so perfect. Anyway, speaking of dialing things in properly, if you do not want to go through the process of adding sound effects back over the audio that you have enhanced, if you have audio that needs a bit of enhancement, let's say there's a subtle air conditioner hum in the background of someone speaking, for example. In that case, you may be able to get away with only having the slider for enhanced speech set to level 2 or 3. This is going to provide a very subtle level of enhancement, but it's something that I really like. I think that there's a lot of benefit to subtly applying this effect to audio that needs it, so don't be afraid to do that if you want to lightly improve your audio. And that's how you use the Enhanced Speech tool in Premiere Pro to make your audio sound incredible. Remember that you can still download my Enhanced Speech presets. They're going to make dialing in your settings even easier because they're going to give you the exact mix amount levels that you need in just one click. You can download these presets for free at the link down in the video description. Thanks so much for watching. Please leave me a comment down below letting me know what other videos you want to see me make about video editing in Premiere Pro, DaVinci Resolve, etc. And have a great day.